Welcome to the GX Dad channel. Today, I'm going to be showing you how to install the Metaltech GX470 standard receiver hitch. This is the same hitch that they sell for their Pegasus bumper, but it also works on the stock bumper too. I chose the Metaltech receiver hitch because, first off, it is very high clearance. It's not going to hang low, which is really good for off-roading. The other thing is it is rated for the full load, towing load of the vehicle, so that's important if I'm going to be towing trailers or bigger items. The other thing is it's a simple bolt-on installation. There's 6 bolts. You have to remove a few things. I'll show you how to do that in a minute. The other thing is it's $89 for this right now. So it's way cheaper than anything else that I've found on the market. But on the flip side, it's made by Metaltech. You know that they're good at fabricating very strong bumpers. This is a very high quality part. And furthermore, if I do decide to upgrade later to a Pegasus bumper, it's forward compatible to that. Now, let me give you a close-up look of the receiver hitch. It is very beefy. It's very heavy. As you can see, it's made out of 1/4-inch thick steel all the way around. And it's welded with these reinforcement brackets. Every single seam is fully welded here. It's a really nice job that they did here. It mounts with these 4 bolts on the front side of the body of the frame. There's 2 more on the bottom, so there's 6 bolts that it bolts up to. It also has the 2 safety chain hooks right there, so you can hook up your safety chains. And here's your receiver. As you can see, it doesn't protrude out too far. This is where your spare tire is going to be, so that's important that this doesn't stick too far back. So overall, it's a really nice, easy to install, heavy duty product. It does come with the hardware you need to install it. And Lexus was kind enough to install 7-pin trailer harnesses already on the GX470. It's actually hidden underneath the bumper. So there's no wiring that you need to do to install this, so why not do it? The only thing it doesn't include is instructions how to install it, so that's why I'm making this video. So let's get into the install. The tools you will need are screwdrivers, a trim pry bar to help remove some clips, Loctite to put on the bolts, a ratchet with a 17mm socket, a 12mm socket, and a 10mm socket, a T30 Torx bit for the mud flaps. First, you will need to remove the door catch. Start by removing the cap, then using a 12mm socket, remove the bolt. Next, remove the trim along the top of the bumper by pulling up and out. Remove the 5 bolts on the top of the bumper using a 10mm socket. Pry out and remove the trim clip on the driver's side. Under the bumper, there are 4 10mm bolts securing the bumper that need to be removed, 2 in the middle, 1 by the driver's side mud flap, and 1 by the passenger side mud flap. Remove the 3 bolts from inside the wheel well holding the mud flap, 1 standard screw on top, and 2 T30 Torx screws on the sides. There is 1 more clip that needs to be removed that holds the splash guard to the wheel well. Repeat the steps for the passenger side wheel well. Gently pull the bumper out and the clips will pop loose, releasing the bumper cover. Using a 17mm socket, remove the 6 bolts holding the existing bracket in place. Add some Loctite to the new bolts and install the new hitch. Get all 6 bolts in first before tightening. As you tighten, make sure the hitch is flush with the frame. Remove the bumper center cutout by removing the 4 blue clips. Install the bumper back on the truck. Measure and cut a hole for the hitch. This may take a few tries to get the cutout as desired. Install the cutout and enjoy. Here is the finished product. It doesn't hang much lower than the stock bumper and doesn't stick out too far. Overall, it's a great looking hitch. Thank you for watching and your continued support of the channel. I have a link to the hitch in the description. check out some of my other install and tech videos, and see you on the trail.